Never in all your career worrying did you imagine what worries could occur concerning the flying cat. You're traveling to a distant city. The cat must travel in a small box with holes.
Will the baggage compartment be pressurized? Will a soldier's footlocker fall on the cat during takeoff? Will the cat freeze?
You ask these questions one by one in different voices over the phone. Sometimes you get an answer, sometimes a clip. Now it's affecting everything you do. At dinner you feel nauseous, like you're swallowing at 20,000 feet. In dreams you weigh fish heads, but the cat has grown propellers. The cat is spinning out of sight.
Will he faint when the plane lands? Is the baggage compartment soundproofed? Will the cat go deaf?
Ma'am, if the cabin were unpressurized, your cat would explode. And spoken in a droll and personal tone, as if the explosion of cats were another statistic.
Hugging the cat before departure, you realize again the private language of pain. He purrs. He trusts you. He knows little of planets or satellites, black holes in space, or the weightless rise of you.
As we stated, the poem The Flying Cat by Naomi Shihab Tsai is about a woman and the worry she has for her cat, who are about to board a plane. Meanwhile, she fears what would happen to her cat and dramatizes the dangers it could be in. It is until she realizes how the cat knows so little and sees that she has been worrying too much. It is told in free verse styles, making it more like a short story being told.
Part of Naomi's life is shown within The Flying Cat. It represents the part of her life where she travels a lot and expresses the worries she could have felt through her life. Or simply, she could be exploring her imagination and how she would react to certain scenarios.
This expresses how it's sort of unbelievable with the amount that people worry in everyday life, that someone would worry so much about a cat going on a plane. It also tells how people may worry so much about some of the simplest things.
The use of repetition of questions are to show the thoughts and worries of a woman for her cat, and shows how people mentally make situations worse for themselves just by thinking negatively.
Through thinking negatively, the woman's fear is shown when she asks questions repeatedly to make sure her cat is safe, escalating the extent that she worries for it. At the same time, this worry caused her to become exhausted, affecting everything she does and even making her feel ill, expressing how people shouldn't use so much energy while worrying.
This represents the desire people have to keep close and protect the things they hold dearly, but at the same time it also shows a subconscious fear of loss that we all may hold.
Once again, the woman repeats a series of questions about the risk her cat could be put in, which further exaggerates that some worry too much and end up escalating fears out of proportions themselves.
A worker of the airline tries to explain that there is nothing to fear and that the woman is freaking out over nothing. But, even so, it is obvious that the woman does not take the joke and keeps on worrying about her cat. This shows that people need to think about the facts of the situation rather than focus specifically on the possible negatives, telling that people should learn to relax slightly more.
This helps her become aware that she worries far too much. It also expresses how people should try to place their faith and trust into something. Then maybe they'll be able to worry a little less.
But I just don't understand. What does this all even mean? And what does it have to do with some flying cat?
The truth is so simple that most ignore it to concentrate on what they think are deeper truths.
For example, one should not worry to such great extents that one's composure is lost and vitality wasted.
When one begins to think too deeply about the complexities of life, fear and worry arise to further those thoughts.
The fear of loss can become overbearing, but every so often, one must look at the world from a simpler perspective.
I think I get it now. If I worry too much, I'll be wasting what precious time and energy I have here. I can't lose myself in my fears, or eventually I'll be consumed by it. I shouldn't worry so much. There's little reason to be when life's more important than that. It mustn't be dwelled in anxiety or fear. It's not just a statement, but also a way to live.
That's right. I don't want to be like that. It's not me. I want to live my life without that worry. I want to live my life without that fear. My life is worth living here.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Thank you, everyone.
Soon.